Thank you. compressed chin. My body alchemized suddenly, a flurry of ash against the air, the black smudge on the green lacquer of the neighbor's house, the foam white of his front porch hovering over the graveyard's limitation. I want to write a poem whose purpose it is to transcribe the language of my experience, the root of my imperfect memory fashioned in bursts, upon trains rolling blunts or in basements heaving alcoholic fumigations in flea-ridden bedrooms or hopscotching over clouds of sewer gas. In every iteration and articulation of pain, chronic, embodied, never otherwise, a desire to die at the hands of electricity or, at the very least, plain good fun, gleefully balanced off eggnog, nursing fistfuls of snow from the balcony's filtration, mixing tears and ice into little glass boots. I must have known all along the function of my strength, that I could weather the lost fate of bear again and again, an attendant to the tomb of my desire, that saturnine earthly altar where I placed my grief like fruit to rot. I was alone in the night. Every time I rose, my shadow heaved against me, above me. Indigo static weathered a flood of humidity. Death rose and claimed the HVAC. I wouldn't have been surprised to find a spider in the bathroom, lulled out of hiding by the sound of piss. Motorcycles in the distance droning. I was alone, and the light licked headless edge against the tile, tricked my asthma out the terracotta pipes dribbling. The undeniable tradition of metamorphosis teaches us that things do not remain always the same. They become other things by swift and unanalyzable process. It was only when men began to trust the myths and tell nasty lies about the gods for a moral purpose that these matters became hopelessly confused, as we're bound 1918. Kneel in the shadow of the candlelights, of the candle's light. Sing upward toward your attendants, to facilitators of your sensorial arrhythmia, shakers of wind, quiver of lip and light. The universe blinks in a fish sprouts ring spouts. The universe blinks in a fish sprouts wings, a plant of her own kind, watered by the springs of epochal fables, unnamed shadow puppets called to dance across the hood of your eyes. Today one thing, tomorrow the next. Nothing breeds nothing means nothing. Death follows death, the sum of all matter dust, the sum of all life dust. Not even soil is soil, nor is light merely light, but momentary aspects reflective of God giving meaning to man in his plight. Your father speaks of energy, particles of logical doubt, Thoughts sprung forth from the caskets he pondered, sweeping the mortuary halls in silence. A lone janitor, questioning the extractive psychosis of a religion organized by slave traders. His conclusion, everything is already everything, all destiny complete. The desire for eternal life breeds only eternal bondage. Nature does not compensate dogma. The wholeness you seek is already whole and waiting, but you have fractured yourself toward modernity, circling the city, forgetting the fire of the sun and fear of the hellscape set aflame by judgment's measure. There is no one here who can address me. You've got my wrong name. All word is energy, and I am the gushing leak, the gasping fish driven ashore to be gifted my mudded wings. I read across an erasure, a dream that is not a dream, or hallucinated, but collected from elsewhere. Edgar Garcia, Boundary Loot, 2012. Three hits in and you remember you're dead and that dead people live just as you do, hunting for water, toiling about the oven, halted before architectures tuned in abstract, misshapen doors that disallow breeze, discouraging spirits from passing through so they hover, casting a thin black mold across the ceiling. Dreamless sleep stagnates intuition. A toxic barrier mounts behind the right eye, beating the sinus dry. The ghost inhabiting your mind pushes her face against the retina's window, turning your attention down toward the fine text of the floorboard's wood grain. Oldest earth in the house where she commands you to sit and remember every frightful battle you endured, the start of time, the end of time, the salted womb in which your consciousness cured. You wake dehydrated to the sound of disembodied fireworks, shimmy on a slip to go eat cold rice over the sink. A void descends, the bland taste of tap water filtered, the bloodless curdle of goat's milk warmed. Somewhere in the walls, a cockroach hides, stroking clean her antenna, moving by the command of a voice you cannot hear, a sense, a smell, a straight line knowledge guarded under the thin lining of her atomic shell. The mind lags, catching a loop of time. The plot of your oozing swampland, the inevitable rubble of your house. You ponder your hand and a tree sprouts. An innumerable chorus mounts the vision with song. A bell chimes. To be alive is to be a deviation of wisdom.